Hi, today I will show you how to fix Hogwarts Legacy stuttering and FPS drops problem. Before moving on to the video, don't forget to leave a like. The video consists of two parts. In the first part, we will optimize our computer for Hogwarts Legacy, which will make our computer run Hogwarts Legacy better. For our first step, we go to the search section and open settings. Then we click on gaming and turn off Xbox Game Bar. After that, we click on Home. We click on System and scroll down. We click on Graphics Settings. Then we click on Browse. Here, we need to go to the file location of Hogwarts Legacy. Your Steam is probably on the C drive. After clicking on the drive where Steam is located, you can select Hogwarts Legacy by opening these files in order. Once this is done, we click on Add. Then we click on Options and select High Performance. Finally, we click on Save. For our second step, we open the Task Manager. After that, we close any unnecessary background applications. Here, we especially need to close applications with the overlay feature. Discord is one of the applications with the overlay feature. Either close this application or turn off the overlay feature in Discord settings. After closing our background applications, we click on Details. Here, we need to find Hogwarts Legacy and change its priority. This needs to be done while the game is open. As my game is not currently open, I will show it on Steam. After opening the game, do the same step for Hogwarts Legacy. Right-click on the program you want to change priority for and click on Set Priority. Then click on High or Above Normal. The third step is updating our graphics card. Since Hogwarts Legacy is a new game, an outdated graphics card may cause problems. So we will update our graphics card. To do this, we open our browser. I have added the download link for Nvidia, AMD and Intel graphics card in the comments section. From there, you can update your graphics card. After we have selected our graphics card, we click on Search. Then we click on Download. We have downloaded the driver. Now we can update our graphics card. If we only want to download the graphics card driver, we tick the Nvidia graphics driver and click on Agree and Continue. Then we click on Next. We updated our graphics card. For our fourth step, we open Steam. Then we right click on Hogwarts Legacy. After that, we click on Browse Local Files. We right click on Hogwarts Legacy again and click on Properties. We click on Compatibility. Then we tick Disable Full Screen Optimizations and click Apply. We press OK and we close this window. Right click on Hogwarts Legacy again and click on Properties. Then click on Local Files. After doing this, we click on Verify Integrity of Game Files. The last thing we need to do before opening Hogwarts Legacy is turn on VSense. To do this, we right-click on the desktop and open the Nvidia control panel. After that, we click on Manage 3D Settings. We scroll down and right-click on Vertical Scenes. Then we click on On. After that, we click on Apply. We have completed the optimization that we need to do before starting the game. Now we need to restart our computer once. In the second part, we will change our game settings. The setting we need to change in display options is the upscale type. If you have an Nvidia RTX graphics card, you can choose DLSS for a better game view. If your graphics card does not support DLSS, you can choose FSR2 as well. Also, you can use Intel's upscale type. Think about the order written on the video when selecting the upscale type. Based on your computer's performance power, you can choose the upscale type according to that order. After that, we go to the Nvidia Reflex section. When we set these settings to On plus Boost, it can cause problems in the game because it is new. So we turn these settings on or off, not the On plus Boost. We turn off VSense from within the game. The reason we do this is that many people on Reddit solve the problems they faced by turning on VSense from Nvidia and turn it off from the game. We don't need to limit the frame rate, so we remove this limit. The Select GPU section is for people with the two graphics cards. I have two graphics cards on my computer. If you also have the two graphics cards on your computer, click on Select GPU and choose better one. After doing this, we click on Graphic Options. Here you have to adjust the graphic settings completely according to your computer. Try a little bit and you can find the best settings for you. Don't forget to turn off ray tracing after selecting your graphic settings. Many people say that the ray tracing is the reason for the problems they experienced. We have come to the end of the video. I hope this video fixed your problem. If the video helped you, don't forget to like the video. You can also subscribe to my channel to support me. Take care and see you in the next video.